Trolley's match. Trolley was an engine from San Francisco, California. He was friends with everybody on the island, but not Green and Duncan, but you'll find out why. "Where exactly is your caboose?" said Trolley in a deep voice. "We don't need a caboose," said Duncan. "Yeah, and we don't need a caboose because I'm a diesel." "So?" "Yeah, and I'm an engine who uses a brake van," said Duncan. But James, Trolley's best friend, says, "It's okay, Trolley. Sometimes engines don't use cabooses or brake vans." But Trolley ignores him and just says, "Whatever." And he watch Diesel, Green, and Duncan go by that night. Trolley was mad.
"I hope those guys get taken out so nervous."
"Oh, calm down, Trolley. Nobody's perfect. I'm just a diesel."
"Whatever. I hope they get taken out of service."
"Hey, hey, hey. Don't say mean things about the other engines."
"Yeah. Back then, when I used to work on my old branch line, I didn't use a caboose,"
said Molly.
"Whatever.
And I'm a rail car, and I don't pull passenger coaches, and I don't use a caboose at all."
"Will you all shut up? Other engines are trying to sleep," said Timothy.
"Well, whatever," said James. "Let's all go to sleep."
"But wait," said Trolley. "Maybe how to get them to the scrapyard is I could bring them, take them off the bridge."
But Green and Duncan were doing their nighttime run, and they overheard Trolley.
"Huh. Let's teach Trolley a lesson tomorrow," said Duncan.
But Trolley didn't do his plan yet, because he fell asleep while all of his friends were working.
"Wake up!"
shouted his driver.
"Wake up!"
shouted his driver again. Said Deacon Duck, said Trolley.
"Come on, you're late for work."
He had lost time. So Trolley just got to Knapford Station, but Green and Duncan were right behind him.
"He's late for work. Let's give him a big push."
"Oh, man, I'm late." Green and Duncan had to wait until it was time for Trolley to leave, and they were off.
"We're going to give you a big push to Farcore Station, Trolley."
"Ah, stop! Stop! Slow down!
We can't slow down. We have to get you to your destination in time. And then they stopped. See? That wasn't that bad, was it? Oh. I'm feeling miserable. He didn't feel really happy yet, because Sir Topham Hatt came next.
I'm very disappointed in you, Trolley. You've caused nothing but trouble.
Sir, let me explain. Blaine.
No! Before you got here, Duncan and Green told me everything. They overheard you that you wanted to scrap them. And the only thing you could do that was send them off a bridge. That was very mean. And plus, since you're friends to everybody on the island, you have been very ruder to Duncan and Green. And as your punishment, you will work at the mainland for 2 weeks, said the Fat Controller. Yes, sir, said Trolley. Oh. Now, I want you to go there right now. Yes, sir, I'm sorry, sir. Trolley was off, and then he spoke to Green and Tom and Duncan. Green, Duncan, how would you like to pull Trolley's train? Sure. We'd like to, sir, said Green. All right, go get your train right now. Yes, sir, they both shouted. And the both of them did not have any problems at all while they were carrying their passenger train. The end.